Puppet Maker is a new feature in Adobe Character Animator that lets you build a customized performance capture animated character in minutes. Choose from 11 built-in styles, each with their own unique looks and personalization options. If that's not enough, you can always import more from our free website or through third-party creators. The characters move around and talk in real time as you make your selections on the left, and the randomize button lets you quickly cycle between several variations, allowing you to quickly create a wide range of diverse puppets. The play section gives you a preview of a character's triggers, which can include everything from background changes to dance moves and other surprises to extend your creative possibilities. When you're done, give your character a name and click the generate button, and you'll be put right into a character animator scene, ready to record or live stream. And if you want to tweak things even more, click the PS icon in the project panel to further customize your character in Photoshop. So whether you're making an animated live streaming avatar, an explainer video, or a full-length multi-character cartoon, Puppet Maker is the easiest, quickest, and most fun way to get started animating with a custom creation. Have fun! Hey everyone, this is Dave from the Adobe Character Animator team, and today I'm going to walk through Puppet Maker. This is a new feature in Adobe Character Animator that allows you to very quickly create a custom character in just a few minutes. So you don't have to worry about opening up Photoshop or Illustrator or adding all this complicated rigging stuff. You can just quickly select a style, make different selections like hairstyle or skin color or clothes and all of that, and then generate a puppet that's ready to go for creating a cartoon or explainer video or a live stream or whatever you want to do with it. So to open up Puppet Maker on the home screen, make sure you're in the latest version of Character Animator, and then go click on this middle panel right here, Puppet Maker, Make a Puppet. So that's going to open up this Puppet Maker window, and I've basically got all my selections over here on the left-hand side, and then my character over here on the right. And you should be seeing your character react to your own movements in the webcam and microphone as you move around and talk. If for some reason you're not, make sure that these icons down here, the microphone and the webcam icon, are both turned on in blue. You can turn body tracking on. If you turn that on, you should see your character's arms move with your own arms, or in some characters, the legs and other limbs will move as well. But for the most part, I usually turn this off. I'll maybe test with it a little bit, but I turn it off because most of the time my hands are going to be down on the mouse, selecting different things. So it's a nice thing to have, particularly for later on when you're animating. But for actual character selection, I find it's best to probably turn it off. You've also got the calibrate button down here. So if something's acting wonky, you can always just click calibrate, and that's going to reset it to a zero position. And then this little three dot icon down here, click on that to switch between your different webcam sources. If your character ever looks really weird and the hands are in a terrible position or whatever, you just want to reset back to normal, just go ahead and click on this little reset icon down here. That's going to refresh your whole scene and get your character back to normal. You also have a selection tool here if your character has draggable limbs that will allow you to drag them. And you have a hand tool here that will allow you to pan and move it around. And that works in conjunction with the zoom over here. So I can zoom in and out to focus on a particular feature, like let's say the head for this particular one. And then I can click on this arrow if I want different zoom options. Most of the time though, I'm gonna just set this to fit, and that's the default. And that's a good starting point. So over here on the left-hand side, we've got three different sections that you can twirl up and down. We've got style, customize, and play. Let's start with style. This is undoubtedly the best part about Puppet Maker. Instead of just one preset style, a lot of character creation systems, they have one style and you either like how it looks or you don't. And if you like it, great. And if you don't, well, too bad, you got to move on. The great thing about Puppet Maker is you have any sort of style that you want. There are 11 pack-in styles here. Plenty of third-party websites are starting to sell or create custom styles as well that you can find online. And then in the future, we're gonna allow anyone to make their own style as well. So there are basically an infinite amount of character creation possibilities. And that really opens up to a really bright future for what's possible with Puppet Maker. So when you hover over these, you're gonna see a bunch of different options, and that'll kind of show you what's possible with each of these styles. It'll show you the name as well as just an overview of what's possible. And then once you click into a character, let's say I like this Watts character, or maybe actually let's go to a different character just to show a different style. Let's go ahead and click on this Mo character. Now that character is going to show up and give me all of its different options. And these can be completely different from the Watts character, right? So these options are completely unique to the character. Every character has their own set of interesting things. To really get a quick sense of a character, my favorite button in this entire thing is the randomize button. If you click randomize, you're gonna get a bunch of different characters and you'll really quickly see the possibilities of what you can do with any given style. So I can try this, or let's move into this monster guy over here, Noodles. And so I can go ahead and click randomize on this one as well. And yeah, you just get a really good sense of what's possible. It's really easy to imagine like creating a cartoon show with, you know, these characters. So let's say this is my main character. And then, okay, here's, you know, the nosy neighbor and here's the friend. You know, it's all in the same style, family. So you can really quickly, you know, create a bunch of stuff and you can use this as a starting point. Or if you want to go back to the default that it started off with, the one that you see here in the thumbnail, go ahead and click the reset button. And that's going to take you back to the original author creation. Once you've selected a style, you can just quickly go through all the different options down here. You'll see they each have a category name. So this guy for face shape, I've got a bunch of different options here. I can go with whatever one I want. Colors, these can all be shown in different ways. This one is chosen to show different X's as the color. So I'll pick maybe this, I like that light blue color there. And so you're just kind of playing around with it and browsing and trying different things. If it has a little cross icon here, that means it doesn't. You're not gonna have any eyebrows, but you can play around with that and see what works. Different eye positions here as well. So just play around with it. Each one is gonna be unique and give you a bunch of really fun different options. So let's do a quick preview of all the different styles. So first we've got Watts. This is a simple torso up human character. A bunch of different options here in terms of just simple flat colored look. Really easy to you know, create a very simple friendly cartoon character in just a few minutes. Next up is Friday. This is a very fashionable character that has a bunch of different looks and options that you can play around with. Nice clothes settings, nice hair settings, a lot of different color options. And it's a full body character as well. So you could add body tracking to the character if you wanted to. And that leads to some really fun possibilities. Next up, we've got a kind of 3D-ish character called the Professional. And this is great for, you know, particularly business oriented things. And I really like the job options that you get down here. So I can be, you know, a doctor, construction worker, tech, you know, store employee, different suits that you can wear, chef or astronaut. And so it's really fun to kind of play around with the different combinations of what you can come up with and get all sorts of people from all sorts of jobs. It's a lot of fun to try. Next up is Mo. This is a really fun, short, stylized character that a ton of different options. I don't think any character has more options than this one. Lots of different, you know, hairstyles, skin colors, clothing options, decals you can put on them, all sorts of things. So this is a really fun one. And again, this is a full body character that has a lot of fun body tracking options as well. Next up is Chibi, and this is a cute little character that has a bunch of different variations and options, different mouths, different eyes, all sorts of different arrangements. You could create very easily, imagine a whole cartoon show created around these characters. A lot of really imaginative, fun, and cute options here. This next one is Mega Robot, and this is basically a build your own Frankenstein creature because you have all these different categories, and you'll notice you could keep everything as a robot or as a Mexican wrestler or, you know, Bigfoot, but it's even more fun to just click randomize and mix them all up in different parts and create all these mix and match style characters. So this one gets a lot of laughs from the kids in particular if you play around with it and let them try to make their own characters. I showed Noodles earlier, but this is a really fun full body character with a lot of different coloring and stylization options, different eyes, different mouths. You can even get a three-eyed variation there. So lots of different possibilities here. Next up is Proteus, and this is a really simple, fun character that you can get a lot of diverse eye styles and head shapes and all sorts of different things. Really fun to play around with this, a lot of diverse options. Next up is Blobby, and this is kind of a fun, bouncy, full body creature character with a lot of different options and styles. So you can get a wide range of characters from this, and not just in the character, actually the backgrounds as well. You'll see, you know, different couches, different window positions, all sorts of stuff like that. You can randomize or pick as well. Then we've got Hunter. And this is a really cool, fashionable, you know, kind of comic book style line art character with a lot of different clothing options. You see like a cape blowing in the wind, different hairstyles, all sorts of different stuff. Really nice to play around with. And then finally, we've got clay. This one is just ridiculous because although it starts as kind of this clay figure, you can jump between all these different options as well, from clocks to flowers to ukuleles to all sorts of different things. So it's a really fun way to create, you know, simple kind of clay sculpted stop motion style characters. Once you're done customizing your character, you can move on to the play section. And all of this is, these are triggers that are going to show up for your character in the recording process. So don't worry about committing to like a background or an eye look or whatever you want right now, because these are going to be options for you that are available later on. But it is for playing around and trying out and testing and seeing, okay, I've got these different backgrounds, or I've got these different, you know, eye positions or hand positions that I can do, points and stuff like that. This one also has the ability to, you know, exit off the screen or go up or down. So all sorts of different things. Each character is going to have their own set of play features. Blobby is another fun one to play around with. He's got, you know, different animations like a wave or look at the phone, or you know, scratch the head, a little jump animation, and then a little stepping, running in place. I got to go to the bathroom or something like that. That's pretty fun. All right, so once I'm done customizing my character, I can go ahead and get ready to generate it. So I'm going to go up here to the upper right-hand corner. Let's call this character Reggie or whatever I want. Click and name it whatever you want. This is the name that's going to show up in your project panel for your actual character. So go ahead and name it to whatever works for you. And then you'll be clicking the generate button. Now, what generate's going to do is it's going to strip out all these details that you didn't select. So just now that I've got this character, I don't care about the other hairstyles or hair colors or props or anything like that. And it's going to strip all those out of my Photoshop file and make my character as optimized and efficient as possible. So I'm going to go ahead and click that generate button. And it's going to start the rendering process here. And there you go. I'm put into a new character animator scene with my character up and running and ready to go. And I've got, you know, my basic puppet here. So if I double click over here in the project panel, I can also see the final rig of my puppet as well. And I can see all the different layers and things that make this character up. Now, I know what some of you might be saying. This is awesome, but I want to change one small detail, right? Maybe this character needs an earring in one ear, or I want to change the logo on the t-shirt to be my company's logo or something like that. Well, luckily, we still have access to the original Photoshop file that this character was generated out of, and we can make further edits inside Photoshop if we want to. So to do that, let's go over here, select our character, and we will click the PS icon down here to edit original. Now, one thing to note for this initial V1 release, Puppet Maker only works with Photoshop files. It does not currently support Adobe Illustrator files, although that's something we hope to do down the road in the future. For now, we're dealing with Photoshop. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and click that little PS icon. So now I'm seeing my full character and all the artwork that shows up in Photoshop. So for example, if I wanted to add, you know, some different hand positions to this character, I could go into here in my hand category and just draw some new hands and add them in and add triggers to them in Character Animator if I knew what I was doing. But if I just want to do like a quick cosmetic thing, like let's say I take this shirt logo and I want to do something different with it. Let's say I'll take that out. Let's delete that. And let's go here. I think I want to take this guy, this handsome looking devil. This is Adobe Chief Product Officer and Executive Vice President Scott Belsky. Let's take that, copy it, bring it here in the shirt, and we'll just arrange it something like this. I hope this doesn't get me fired. Let's try a different little transparency to blend it in a little bit more. And that's looking good. Okay, so now I can go ahead and save this, Command S on Mac, Control S on Windows, and that's automatically gonna save and link back to Character Animator. So let's jump back into Character Animator. And there we go. Now my beautiful edit has been made to this character, and this is just looking exactly like I wanted it to. So you can use, if you know what you're doing around Photoshop, you can use Puppet Maker as a great starting point, and then add the little details on top of your character to add a little bit of a unique quality and take it to the next level. Now, there are other websites out there that have additional styles that you can download. On our free website, we've got 3 free current ones, and we'll be adding more to these in the future. But if you download one of these, what you're looking for is what we call a .maker file. And so this is gonna look pretty similar to a .puppet file, which is the usual character animator file that includes rigging data plus the original Photoshop or Illustrator artwork. In this case, a maker file, it's adding even one more layer on top of that, right? It's adding the rigging of the puppet, the original Photoshop file, as well as all of the customization options that you have as well. So to add a new maker file into your system, all you have to do is just double click on it and it's gonna open up. And there we go. Now I've got this new character added in that I downloaded from the website, and I can try all the different styles here, see what this character has to offer. This one has an on button that shoots fire out or does different things, different backgrounds. So you can see how in the future there's going to be a lot of really cool styles that you could add to your collection here. And if you ever want to remove any imported styles from your list, just search on your computer for .maker and you'll find them. They're usually saved in your documents folder, Adobe, Character Animator, and you will see them in a Puppet Maker folder. And if you delete those maker files, then the next time you load things up, they won't show up. Now, I know there's probably some of you out there that really want to make your own styles as well. And that's something that we're working on and we hope to get out in the future. Right now, it's a really complicated process. Not only do you have to do the Photoshop file and the rigging, but then you also have to add the customization on top of it. It's just a lot of layers, a lot of options. There's right now some scripts and stuff you have to run in Character Animator to make it work. It's way more complicated than it needs to be. So we're working on making that system as user-friendly and accessible as possible so anyone can create their own style. We want to make sure we get that right and not something that we just rush out the door just because we can. So keep an eye out for it. It will come in the future. So please stay tuned. All right, so that is Puppet Maker. We cannot wait to see what you create with it. So please, whatever you make with it on social media, please use hashtag Character Animator. That's how we find it and check out your great work. And if you have any questions about any issues that have come up or any questions you have about Puppet Maker, the best place to get help is the official Character Animator forums. All right, that's it for today. Thank you so much for watching and have fun.